upon people's hearts and lives. Many were healed, some in the service per se, and some in the streets, and some in businesses, and some in motel rooms, and in lobbies of motels and hotels. God began to do this in a wonderful way. There was a response. Many people came from these places. They were desirous for God to help them. They were hungry in their heart. And Jesus said he come to feed the hungry. And so the hungry were well fed. One of the things, as far as I was concerned, a few years ago, Jesus found me. And you know, he came to seek those that were lost, and I was. And God began to move. But then the second benefit, besides a person giving their heart to Jesus, is being healed and being healthy. And Jesus said that he didn't come just for those that were healthy, but he came for those who were sick.
Yeah.
And those who are sick need a doctor, and Jesus is that doctor. He came to help them. All the ministers in our group, some from Africa, some from India, some from all over the United States, expressed this joy, and this joy became mine. There's nobody like Jesus. There's nobody that can help you like Jesus. And there's no one who really cares about you like Jesus. And he'll heal you in your spirit. He'll heal you in your body. He'll take care of your every need. You can trust him to do just what he says he will do. And you can care. You can begin to count on him. Martin Luther found a few years ago at the Reformation, he found that the grace of God, it says, for by grace are ye saved. And that brought the Reformation. Now with this new movement of God, God is speaking grace to all believers and grace to all in the world. He's a God of grace. He's a God of love. And he's a God of mercy. If you have a need, fax us, call us, and we're sure that God will meet that need, and you will be able to count on him for everything you need.
Yeah. Dave, do you have some miracles that happened this weekend that you can think of?
Well, one of the neatest ones is we were at the Super 8 Motel in, well, it's a suburb of Madison. What town was it?
Verona.
Verona.
Carrie was the supervisor's name at the hotel we got to be friends with.
And she had back pain, so she allowed us, after we talked to her a while, just as friends, and I was telling her about all the miracles we've seen, so she had a back and neck that was giving her trouble, so we prayed, and the pain started going away. And we invited her to come, and she'd been to a lot of different meetings, and she wasn't quite sure, but as we were having dinner the next night, she called and wanted to know where there was, so she came, and she got blessed. As far as I know, that she didn't have any pain when we left the motel. But she got to experience people that really cared for her, loved her. She got a couple new friends, I believe. They're going to work on a project of, what is it?
With homeless ministry. And there was one lady that had the idea of buying a hotel, an old hotel, and setting it up for homeless people. And so Carrie has that background that she can help her with that. And then there was another lady who they've been helping with the ministry in Nashua, a homeless ministry. And so that God just connected all of them. It was so cool. At the hotel, there was two of them from Nashua that were checking out. And because Carrie had been to that meeting, and they started talking about it, and they connected again, and she gave them Michelle's number. And so I just know God is going to do something mightily through that connection. And I know Carrie's back was partially healed while we prayed for her, and then it just gave her enough encouragement to want to go and be at the meeting Saturday night. And so I know she got more at the meeting too, and I just thank God for what all he's doing with people. And there was Larry and Dave and I and went out to lunch, Saturday, and met up with a waiter, and I asked him, like I usually do before we went to pray for our meal, I said, we're going to pray, and we just wondered if there was anything that you needed prayer for. We're at Chili's restaurant. And he kind of looked at me, he said, what? And I said, well, we always just pray for people when we go to pray for our meal. Would you like prayer? And he said, yeah, forgiveness. And it was just like, oh, wow, cool. So when we went to pray, we prayed for him. And he's just a young guy. And he came back and you could just see he was just happy because somebody cared enough to ask if they would pray for him. Mm-hmm. And while we were eating, there was a thunderstorm outside. And all of a sudden, there was lightning, and it hit the roof of the building. It came down through the light fixture right in front of all three of our faces. You know, the light is just like right in the middle of the table, right there, right about where our faces. And it was just like a blue and white streak of lightning that came down. And I was like, oh my gosh, did you see that? And there was a lady that was sitting behind Larry at the next table, and she goes, I saw it. And she said the same thing I did. And then when she got up from the table, she stopped by, and it was just like, wow, was that not amazing? And it was like, after it happened, I could just feel this warmth in my chest. It's like, I think God just made a connection somehow with me. I don't really know what it meant yet, but that's okay. My husband been hit by lightning a couple times. I guess it was kind of my turn. But after that, then we went to leave, and that young man that was our waiter came up to us, and I said, you know what? God loves you very much. And I said, he forgives you. He loves you so much. And I kind of grabbed his elbow, and I said, you know, I said, you have a call on your life. And I said, God has mighty works for you to do. And he was just smiling. And then I grabbed his chin and I said, you know, you remind me of my son. I said, you have a beautiful smile. Then he was just beaming after that. You could just see him kind of just walk away, and there was just like a hop in his step. And, you know, God can just transform people in a short time because they know that God, it's like God speaks through people and he tells them things. And I just, out of the whole weekend, there's so much that happened, so many people that got healed, but it's just so neat to see people transform before your eyes, and that God does that. Just that made my day. Can you think of anything else?
Well, another neat thing was there was, I don't know, 40, 50 ministers, some IMI, most of them are IMI, but there was other walks. And one pastor and his wife, it was a team. He was limping. I said, what are you limping around here for? We pray for you. So we sat him down in the chair. We sat him down in the chair, and I found out that it just seems to work better if I can get them just to relax their legs. And I just called for the fire of God to come up and restore it. It was some kind of like neuropathy, or I have a hard time with medical names. But his legs started jumping and pulsing, and he says, oh my God, the pain's gone. So I usually do is get that person up doing something they couldn't do, so it exercises their faith to know that Jesus healed them. That they don't have to just doubt, like, well, I think it did. I'll get them up doing something they couldn't do before. And he was just like the happiest guy in the world that somebody took the time to minister to other ministers. Yeah. Sometimes the ministers are left out. They hear everybody's problems, but nobody pours into them. And it's kind of a gift that we've had, that over the years we've got to minister to hundreds of ministers all over the nation. And that was spoken over us, and the day after we got married, that we were going to minister to ministers and rulers and people in high places. And like, how did God use a guy that drives a truck, does construction work? But he can use anybody. Doesn't matter where you're at. God just wants a surrendered vessel that he can use.
Yeah.
If he says go, all you have to do is be obedient.
Well, Larry, I know that you've had God touch you, and you've had miracles. God has healed you from different things. Can you give us a...
In 1987, the July 31st, I was stricken with a stroke and paralyzed on my entire right side. My eye drooped and saliva and paralyzed on this right side. And during that time, this between 87 and 1995, God began to restore me. Then in the last 2 years, God has continued to restore me so that I can do normal activities. I can mow my grass. I can drive a car. I can do all those things necessary. Preach the gospel, pray for people. And God has given me a wonderful new lease on life. And he's begun to show me that there are many, many other areas that I'm going to work in. I'm thankful for Jesus. I'm thankful for what he said in Isaiah 41, verse 9 and 10. God said, I've not rejected you. Believe he's not rejected you. He didn't reject me. He accepted me. And I have not, so do not fear, God said, because I haven't rejected you. Then he also said, for I am with you. And Jesus is with me. That I want to please Jesus because Jesus found me. Then he raised me right from the dead. No chance. I also hit a train in 1970, and they pulled me out, what was left of me, and God restored me from that accident, which was a horrific thing, and God blessed me and restored me to complete health, and he's in process of doing that now. And I count it a privilege to say that Jesus does anything that you have need of. And he suffered and died and paid all your debts on the cross. They're paid for.
Amen.
And God's grace has given you this. It is free, and you can't earn it, and you can't change it or add to it. He's given you just what you need. He gave me just what I needed, and he continues. He gave me a wonderful wife, Jewel, who's been my companion now. Our year anniversary is in 2 days, and he's begun to show us that we have much to do in the work of the kingdom.
Yes.
And that he cares about people. And at the last part of my life, I'm completely recycled and wanting to do everything that will please God.
Amen.
So how did you two meet?
That's a story that's very funny. I don't tell many things public, but this is a good one. Someone said, you better call her. I called her. I didn't call her again for 3 months. One day in my recliner, I got a strong inclination to call her. So I finally found her phone number. It took a half an hour. And I called her, and I said, I'd like to come see you. We stood and held hands and prayed in the kitchen of her house. And in 48 days, we were married.
Jewel. And I want to hear Jewel. Jewel, what were you doing before you met Larry?
I was praying before he called me. I was sitting out in my driveway in the sun praying because I was a little lonely. I'd lost my husband 4 years before. And then I just finally said, okay, God, you know what I need. And Larry called me. So
he answered your prayer pretty quick.
Yeah, I did.
Thank you, Jesus.
And we've seen that a numerous times. If you pray with your heart, not your mind, if you pray with your inner being, God just answers them types of prayers. That so many people are so got so much head knowledge instead of heart knowledge. Mm-hmm. When you pray with all your heart, all your being, the prayers get answered.
Right. When I just gave up, I always thought I told God what I needed. But when I gave up and said, God, you know what I need. And he filled my needs.
Yeah, he seems to do that pretty good for us when we finally give up and give it to him and don't take it back. I've had that happen a few times.
Well, that's kind of how me and Patty met. We've known each other about a year now. How many miracles have you seen? Does any stand out?
Oh, in your meetings?
Well, just yeah. Anywhere.
At your house, wherever we've had a meeting.
I hear miracles.
Hi, Brett.
Almost almost every day or every week from you in the meetings I go to there. I see them all the time. And, I'm just kind of stepping out myself to pray for people, and I, like Sunday night, I met this guy who had come out of the halfway house, and I could see that he was a very needy person. I've seen him several times before, and God just gave me a lot of compassion for him, and he was telling how sick he was, and so I just, and I prayed over him, I said, you know, God has clothed, because he knew he did a lot of bad things in life. God has clothed you with the robe of righteousness, and you have all these promises that are in this robe of righteousness. And he was just smiling, and I said, and healing was one of the things he provided for you. And so then I went to the service and went out afterwards, and he came out afterwards and followed me out, and just a grinning, and I was telling him more about how Jesus loved him and how righteous he was in Jesus, and he was just so excited. So I expect to meet up with him again and try to disciple him a little, tell him how awesome Jesus is, and follow up on his healing.
That's great. You can do it in the marketplace. Anybody can preach the gospel. I know you guys had some home meetings for a while, and I know a lot of people got healed at your meetings. One lady had something wrong with her arm.
Yeah, a lady came, and she was going to have surgery on her shoulder because she had fallen and damaged her shoulder. So she was going she lost her job and everything because of it. And so Larry and I prayed over her, and she was instantly healed. She just raised her hand and said, I haven't been able to do this since I fell. And she was just so excited. And a month or two later, she called me, and she's still healed. And she says, I'm getting other things on my body are getting healed now. My legs are getting healed. And so it's just really exciting to see that happen right in our living room, just Larry and I.
Well, I remember a meeting one time where the glory of God just came in.
Yes.
That was one of the neatest things that I'll never forget.
I was on the floor.
It was so strong.
Awesome. It was just like, whoa.
And my friend Dan Ring, who never falls over, fell over backwards in the spirit, and a number of other people.
Any other miracles?
There's a young man, there's about five, but there's a young man named Dino who had hepatitis and had something wrong with his liver.
Oh, yeah.
And they were in some locations. There's a group upstairs ministering, and there's a group downstairs ministering. So he told us that he had a need, and so I prayed with him and two others, and in just a few short weeks, he went back and had his liver and checked, and all of this area that has to do with hepatitis, and he's well. He's been healed over a year. And God is doing many things for him that are mighty. And then we have another one that there are several people that had bad hips and legs were not operating right that have been healed. And that has been outstanding in my mind to notice their progress.
Yeah.
We had one little short woman who couldn't walk properly, who after prayer just about a little over a month ago was able to run and dance, and I met her again, and she's still running and dancing.
Thank you, Jesus.
And she's probably almost 55 or 60, you know, not a senior citizen, but mightily moved.
Yeah.
Now, God has moved in my body continually and given me more and more healing and strength, and the doctors are amazed, and I'm going to see one soon. That he's doing some follow-up work, and I know that they don't know that I had high blood pressure and I had trouble with my elimination in my body, but God has taken care of that.
Yeah.
I can tell you that it's been continuous and ongoing, and he's kept me and strengthened me.
Yes.
Well,
we were just... Sorry, hang on, honey. I guess we were offline for the first part. If you guys are still hanging in there, I guess it's working now. So thank you, God. We've been praying that it come on. It'll be recorded, but sorry if you missed the first part of it. Go ahead.
Well, I was just thinking, when you had your stroke, They said that, didn't the doctors say that you'd never get out of bed?
They said my legs would be shorter, that one would be shorter, that I'd had to give up everything, that I just, well, consign myself to being in the wheelchair, more or less, and being semi-paralyzed for the rest of my life. When I came to Iowa, I parked my wheelchair in the basement. The last I saw of it, someone was putting it out so someone could recycle it outside of my house. That's the last, that was one, about a month and a half ago.
Praise God.
And how many people have you seen that didn't know this happened, that they came to our house, we say a short prayer, and then we'll have the new people out doing the same thing?
Dozens and dozens, and they're meeting with excitement. We have someone named Becky in Illinois. God's using her, and God's working on her mightily. And many people in several churches and several localities, southern Iowa, I don't know, many other neighboring states, they're actually practicing what they learned. What happened to them, they're able to turn again and use their faith that God has gave them, and they're able to not only duplicate, they're able to reach more people that have needs. And this is what that second explosion of grace that God is giving to the church, this second explosion of grace is being preached by many. Andrew Womack, Derek, different other ones like this are preaching it, and Joseph Prince and others, and they're preaching it, and people are starting to believe.
Right.
God cares about you. Mm-hmm. He's already done the work. You can't add to it, just accept it.
Take it.
Yeah.
Well, there's a couple of them that stood out, and me being hit by lightning a couple of times, and it was the 33rd building that the lightning bolt come down while we were eating Saturday up in Madison at Chili's. But what happened to you in the kitchen this winter? You're getting some ice and some ice water.
We were praying for a young girl that's out in the van now taking care of our daughter. And we went upstairs and we gathered around her and prayed. And I filled up a big hungry man glass with ice and water. And I turned around and I felt a tremendous jolt on my whole right side, and the cup went up about 14 or 16 inches, whatever, how high you can jerk. When it got past my face, then the ice went upward and all things, and I emptied the glass. And my arm stayed numb for a length of time, maybe an hour, hour and a half, before it returned to normal feeling. And I know that was from God. I know that was an expression of him about his mighty power. I knew he cared, and I knew he cared for the person we prayed for, but it was for me. It was to show me. Then in our bed just a few days ago, a lightning bolt hit a few feet from our house. It took out the server on our two computers and didn't dysfunctionalize the server. And it came into our, the jolt came into our bedroom, I know that. So I know God is doing what he's doing, mainly to get my attention, and I hope if he doesn't have to send too many of those to you to get your attention, but he may. And, you know, God is a God of power and a God of might, and he's a God of love and mercy. Remember, he chose you, and he cares for you.
Well, another one that sticks out in my head is there was a young man that came in that hadn't been around this. He came in with the guy I call the cowboy because I don't remember names.
Talton Tony.
And he didn't believe in any of this. So we usually set a chair in our home meetings in the center. It keeps everybody in one accord. God loves unity. And we prayed over a couple people. So he was like the third one we prayed over. And he didn't believe anything, so he stands up, and the next lady comes in. I said, well, you're going to speak a word over it. He said, I've never done anything like that. I can't. He says, all of a sudden, he had a vision. I said, just tell her what you've seen. And he had three or four visions, and I said, okay. And a guy came to our house that had an inoperable brain tumor. And I said, now you're going to lay your hand. The Bible says if you lay hands on the sick, they shall. And he put his hands on the back of his head where the brain tumor was sticking out a little bit. And it was like a lightning bolt come down his arm. He jerked. He looked at his hand like it was loaded. And we have a lot of fun with this. It was pretty funny to be there. I said, now, see if you can find that brain tumor. And he felt, and there was no lump where there used to be a lump. Mm-hmm. Any other ones stick out in your remembrance? Any other things happen this weekend?
We went to pray for a young man in Kansas City. And I haven't got the confirmation back. He's had brain tumors inoperable, and they only could get part of them. We went a few months ago, and prayed for him in his nursing home. And he's someone I contacted. But I'm sure that he's still living. He's able to get around. He hasn't lost the ability to move and to feed himself or drink. And one day soon, we hope to be able to contact him and find out all the things that he's doing. But the last word I had is that he was able to do anything.
Well, we're going to turn a song on. We're going to make a short version of it tonight since we had some technical difficulties at first. So, and the song is I Can Only Imagine. It's our favorite song. And so if you just want to sit back and relax and just, I mean, the pictures are pretty if you want to watch it, but if you want to just sit back and listen to the music and just have time with God. Sometimes people don't take time for God and just to listen and see if God tells you something during this time. Thank you. During that short time and that you can do that again sometime, whether we're on the air or not, because I know that God speaks to me when I just take the time to listen to him. And just to let you know, we're on the air every Monday night from 9 to 10 o'clock p.m. and it's DesMoinesAmplified.com. if you're here already, thanks for signing in. And if there's any prayer requests, you can put it on the chat page. And my computer's not working, but Brett's is, and he can tell us what you're asking for prayer for. And then we have a meeting every Sunday evening at Open Bible Fellowship in Ankeny. It's at 5:30 in the evening, and it's at 1125 Southwest 3rd Street in Ankeny. And we just pray for people, and God heals them, sets them free of whatever they have that's wrong with them. And sometimes they get saved and get filled with the Holy Spirit. God is doing a mighty move there, and we love to see God working wherever it is that You know, we go, we ask him what he wants us to do, and sometimes he tells us before we even ask. So we just love that we can do God's work.
Well, what happened this week? What stood out at Sunday night? The homeless guy that came in.
Oh, yeah. We had a friend that brought a homeless guy in, and he was set free.
He came in drunk, obnoxious.
Yeah.
People loved on him. They poured into him.
Yes. We've got a lot of people that come to our meetings that are their regular attenders, and they're really on fire for God. And some of the people have been to our home meetings. We had them for about a year and a half in our home before we started at the Open Bible Church. We ran out of room, and Wally had asked us to have workshops there on Sunday nights. He'd been to one of the home meetings and liked what he saw. And so there's people there that pray with us. It's not just Dave and Patty. It's all of people. Larry and Jewel have prayed with us and prayed for people. And God just shows up in a mighty way. We thank God for all that he's doing. I just love to see people transformed. It's just amazing to see what God can do through the love of all the people that come to the meetings and wherever we go. The Holy Spirit, we just ask him to go before us and to make the way for us. And he does every time. He makes divine appointments for us. It's just wonderful.
Well, this guy came in. He wasn't his right mind. He was trying to interrupt the service. We didn't pay much attention to him because we didn't want to take the focus off of what we were doing. And then we came up for prayer. And he really didn't want it. And people brought him up and people prayed over him. And pretty soon, a lady got a word from God on him and started speaking to him. And before long, she had him up singing Jesus Loves Me in front of the church. And later on, he was in his right mind, sober, talked like a normal person.
Thank you, God.
And we've seen that numerous times. We've had one-on-one encounters where somebody was so bad, you didn't think they were listening. All of a sudden, they were just in the right mind.
Yep, and we got the pleasure of praying where IMI ministers at Tom Stammen's group, Impact International. Impact Ministries International, yeah. And we went to the conference this weekend for ministers, and he asked all the ministers to get up and pray. There was people at the meeting that weren't, and I know the first night there was probably at least 30 of us up there, I think. And the second night there was even more. And he had us get up and pray for some people. Do you remember what the first few people were that we prayed for? I couldn't remember. I know there was a couple people, and then I remember after that.
The one lady, she wanted more of the presence of God, and she came up, and the next thing, she was just what I call shaking and baking.
Yeah.
We'd seen her the next day, and she was still vibrating and shaking. Mm-hmm. God was doing a whole work on her. And a lot of times we don't know exactly what God's doing, but the next time we've seen them, they're a totally different person. They're out moving in the gifts. They're out moving in the supernatural. One guy came up after the meeting, and he wanted me to pray, and I prayed for, I don't know, 30-some deaf people that they've had their hearing restored. Some didn't even have an ear or hole they were born with. And I said, well, wait till tomorrow night. Come in when the presence of God is thick. Come in expecting. Then I no more touched him, and he went flying. And I haven't heard the results. He was still laying there when I left, and I started ministering to other people.
There was one guy, the one lady said she saw a ball of fire up by us, and that's why she came up to get prayed for. And God touched her mightily. And then after that, there was a young man that said, I've been sitting back there watching you guys. He's like, I want you to pray for him. I want whatever God has for me. And so we prayed for him, and he got hit by the power of God. And I'm not sure what God did for him, but I know something.
He had something internal, too. I don't remember what. It had something to do with blood or blood work.
Okay.
High blood pressure, I believe.
Okay, yeah.
And we've seen a lot of people. One lady had high blood pressure of 240 over 2-something and a bad back and bad knees.
Oh, yeah, Jan.
Yeah, another friend of Patty's that And anyway, I knew she didn't have the faith for the whole package deal. The first thing we're doing to raise your faith is we're going to pray for knees, because we prayed for hundreds of knees. People didn't have to have knee surgery. So as we touched her knees, she felt parts moving. The people touching their knees felt parts moving. I said, now stand up. We're going to pray for your back. And all of a sudden, she kind of wiggled a little bit, and her back straightened up. She had disintegrated discs, like five of them, I believe, so many people. And I said, now you had the faith. You got two new knees and a new back. You know that. Your pain's gone. I had her bend over and run around a little bit. And now we're going to pray for your blood pressure. And then it got late at night. It was after a candle party, of all things. It seems like wherever we go, no matter if it's a Pampered Chef party, a candle party, wherever, it ends up to be a Holy Ghost meeting. So we're going to pray for your blood pressure. We got home, was getting ready for bed, and they checked her blood pressure. It was, what, 111 over 70-something?
It was just almost half of what it was, and it was normal. It was way down there, and it's just like, it's the lowest she'd had it been in, I think, like 20 years. So, you know, when I would see her, it's like her face was always red because her blood pressure was always high, but now it's gone down, and she didn't have to take the medicine anymore.
Yeah.
Thank you, God.
I remember this guy who came to the picnic at your place, and he had back pain for, like, years, 8 years?
Yeah, Jim was a friend of ours, and he brought him. Wasn't he a painter, too?
Yeah, he painted with him for
years.
And he was just glowing because after all those years, they couldn't kill the pain with any medicine. He was free of pain.
Yeah.
And he was just so happy, and he got saved through that, I heard.
Yeah.
And it was nice to see him, just see the glow on his face from what God had done for him.
Yeah, it just transforms people when they, you know, when they're hurting and they're in that pain, they're just having a hard time making it through life. And then when God takes away all that pain, it's just amazing to see how they are transformed.
Oh, and he's about, I don't know, 50s, somewhere in that.
Mm-hmm.
And he said the next day he had to climb ladders, painting. I don't know, it was a Hy-Vee store or something. And he said he was climbing up and down, making the young guys look slow again. So he didn't just get a healing. He got more than it.
Yeah.
He got restored.
Yeah, restored, right.
Yeah, God can make people. You know, he created us. He can do whatever he wants. As long as we have the faith and we want to receive it, he can just turn back the clock.
He wants to do it for us.
Yes.
He's just waiting for us to receive it.
Yes, you're right. Mm.
Something I learned as a young person was, and I had some life and death situations that if my prayer didn't get answered, somebody was dying in a short time, that pray until you get a breakthrough. It isn't how long you pray, it's how deep.
Yeah.
Keep
pray
going.
Deeper. And most of my prayers anymore are very short, but I've been doing this for a long, long time.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing I want to encourage you is to pray and expect.
Yes.
It's the expectation.
Yes.
Yeah.
I've worked
with
churches that everybody in the church has been divinely healed, so when somebody's sick, they expect God to do what he says he does.
Right, that's good.
And
I agree.
And that's what faith is. You're expecting. Mm-hmm. You're not just hoping. So many people get hope and faith mixed up. Well, I hope God hears. Well, I know he does. I've seen too many of them. And I just, when I pray, I expect God to do what he said he does as long as I do what he told me to do.
Yes.
The other thing that I've used, I call them, I work with a lot of people that haven't been to a church a lot of people in treatment centers and out of prison, is I keep it very simple. And I look in the book of Acts, and they had a very simple gospel.
Yes.
Jesus is the answer.
Mm-hmm.
And all we're supposed to do is release the kingdom. And I've seen so many people on the street, because they didn't have anything blocking them, that they just received it so easy. I mean, some of these were big, tough guys that they weren't going to believe in any of this. And we've seen backs, knees, about anything. It doesn't matter what it is. God build us. But I always try to find one other person, because the Bible says if two shall agree on anything.
Right.
Yeah.
I've been to healing service where they have the whole church pray. They pray and pray. And then somebody asked me, hey, will you pray? I said, well, yeah, but we're going to do it God's way, not man's way. And I'll look around, and I'll see one other spiritual person, and we'll go pray, and their leg becomes whole. They get up out of the wheelchair, whatever it is. It doesn't matter. It isn't about me, but I'm taking God's written word, and doing it as close to exact as I know how, and he honors that. Mm-hmm. He can't honor my word or Patty's or anybody else. He can only honor what mm-hmm. his word is.
And I agree. One of the keys is to expect.
Yes.
That's real important, to expect something to happen when you pray.
Yeah.
Jesus said, come to me. So I have a question. When are you going to come?
Yeah.
I mean, you're going to start today? You're going to start that way? But if you start, if you take one step toward God,
right.
I can tell you, he's already taken 10 toward you, and he's real close to you, and you may know that he is up near you. And if you go to bed at night, you can ask God to be with you, and you know he's there. He's in your heart, he's in your spirit, and he's near you. So if you, Jesus said to come, all ye that are weary and heavy laden, come on. You'll never forget.
And I just remembered, God brought to my remembrance a couple. They're pretty funny. We have a lot of fun doing this that people don't think that we're, I don't know, serious enough. I said, well, look at the fruits. People get healed, they get saved, they get set free. But I was in a treatment center, and this kid, young man, that he'd been living in his car for years. He was a meth addict. I seen him in a treatment center, and I said, if you don't believe me, you go up to your room, and you get on your knees, and I will guarantee you God will answer.
Yeah.
You pray with all your heart, he'll answer. The next time I seen him, his eyes were all big, and he says, you ain't gonna believe what happened to me. I said, well, tell me about it. He says, I got on my knees, and I couldn't get up. He said, I think there was an angel holding me down there until I got everything out of me that needed to get out, and he was just transformed.
Yes.
And I got him plugged into another church in another town.
Thank you, Jesus.
Another one was, it was so funny because this was a big bodybuilder. He'd been in prison for a while, and they don't have a lot to do, so they lift weights and do things. And I don't ever work out as such. I worked hard all my life, but he was trying to get the sugar open, and them granules would always jam the thread. So the day before, he was supposed to do 10 years because he missed his last chance. And I got him to go up to his room, and they allowed me to go up with him, and we got on our knees. And I said, we're going to ask God to do a miracle. As long as you're sincere, God will answer. So the next day I seen him. I said, wait a minute. You told me you wouldn't see me for 10 years. What happened? He says, Dave, you ain't going to believe this, but that judge told me all I had to do is do 2 years in a halfway house. So his job was to clean the tables and do the kitchen stuff.
Wow.
And he was trying to get this sugar open. He was banging on the table, and we'd played around with the weights before, and he was showing me how tough he was, and he's banging on this and grunting and groaning, and all of a sudden I said, give it here a minute. And I touched it with one finger, and I just touched it, and I said, now try it now. And he's trying to argue, like, I said, just try it now. And he touched it with his two fingers and his thumb, and it opened right up. Mm. He says, how did you do that? I said, well, I'll tell you, but I don't think you'll believe me. And as he walked away, he knew that it was something supernatural that God had done.
Yes.
It was just to prove him one more time.
Yes.
Did he figure out that was God then?
Yeah, I believe he did. Wait a minute. This guy, too many weird things happen around him.
Well, and obviously if he didn't have to do 10 years, he only had to do 2 years in a halfway house. God answered his prayer.
We have another guy, and I'm not going to name any names, that he became a friend of mine, a dear friend. That he could never get over drinking too much, and he had 6 DWIs. Which means you go to jail in Iowa for a long time.
Yeah.
I said, if you're really serious, before you go to court, stop by the house, me and Patty will pray. He calls me, walked out of court, and he says, you ain't going to believe this, but they said it's a second offense. And he says, I can keep my job and keep my business. And I talked to him a few months ago, and he's even driving a car again, which they said he would never do.
Oh, wow, I didn't know that.
And he believes in
miracles. Yeah, I saw him drive his car. I never even thought about it. Wow.
Hmm. And we don't want to tell everybody he's garbage or nothing, just that it doesn't matter where you are. We had another minister friend. He actually has an apostolic training ground out of Florida, and he was running a homeless ministry, did a lot of things that weren't too good. And the President of the United States called him in. This has been a while ago. and wiped away his whole past.
Yeah.
He's got a big church in Florida now.
Mm.
He says, it doesn't matter where you are, what you've done. And he was in the cabinet. He was an ambassador for one of the administrators.
Mm.
So God wiped away his financial burdens, his records. He's just like Jesus. When he washes you in the blood,
mm-hmm.
you're a new creation.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter where you've been. It doesn't matter what you've done. I don't recommend doing bad things. But if you're sincere, if you believe in your heart, he can wipe away your past.
Amen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We have a good friend of ours that he's had his taxes wiped away. And it's
mm-hmm.
just amazing what God can do. You just think there's no way.
Mm-hmm.
But God can do anything.
And it was a fairly large sum of money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, he's got a whole new life again.
Yeah. Thank you, God.
What else do you have from... There's something we're missing. There was something else that was big.
Well, I know there was a young girl that we prayed for. She had a wrist thing on one of her arms. It was like a wrap. I don't know if she sprained her wrist or whatever, but... We prayed for it, and the pain left her wrist. And we prayed for this guy Pete. He had neuropathy in his legs, and we just
he was a minister.
Oh, okay. We had one in each hand, and when we were done praying, the pain was gone.
Mm-hmm.
So God, thank you.
There was a lady at our house too when that time when we all stood together in this. Spirit came so strongly
yeah.
upon us that had a band on her arm, and she took it off, and it's still at my house.
she's never
come back after it, so I'm assuming that she was completely healed.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember that might have been the same lady.
Diane.
And she just, no, I think it was another lady.
Mm-hmm.
She called me, or she emailed me, well, both, and she said that she's just, God has just turned her around. She was depressed, and she's came out of that. She's lost a bunch of weight,
mm-hmm.
and that just her whole attitude and life and all the hurts and pains are gone, and it's just like, God, you are so good. All we have to do is have the faith.
Well, it's on my heart right now. We had to pray for Juliet's, somebody in her, but we're
her
just
father-in-law.
Yeah, just anybody that has any need right now, we're just going to say a simple prayer that God just heals anybody, whatever your need is. Heavenly Father, we're just asking you
yes.
let the anointing flow over these airways, anybody in need, no matter what it is, whether you need new eyes, new ears,
yes.
whether you have an intern, whether there's something missing.
Yes.
There's all kinds of miracles of people growing new organs. We prayed for one guy and he had an extra artery grow around his heart. Heavenly Father, you've done it before.
Yes.
We're just asking anybody with the faith to reach out. Reach out.
Yeah.
Whatever you have to do, whatever you have to do, touch, just believe.
Yes.
If you have to do something as an act of faith that God puts it on your heart, just we thank you for the answered prayers and the emails and the messages that we're going to get. Just
yes.
When he leads and you follow, he's already wanting to do it. He just wants somebody to declare it, to speak
Amen.
It out.
Mm-hmm.
And we thank you for these answered prayers.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll just remind you again, we're here every Monday night. If you've got a friend or family member, you can chat online with us and ask us to pray for them, and we'll pray for them. We had a lady that was... shaked and baked a couple weeks ago, and she could, after we prayed for, I mean, this is over the air, you know, the online radio. Thank you, Jesus. She was shaking and baking for 2.5 hours afterwards. She was texting a friend of a friend that came through, and God was doing a mighty work in her. And so we know we prayed for people over the phone, and God has healed them. And so just come online with us and let us pray for you. If you've got a friend or family member that you want prayer for, that's fine too. And just to remind you again, on Sunday nights we meet, if you want to come in person, to Ankeny Open Bible. at 5:30. Bring people and just expect a miracle. God shows up every time. And the address is 1125 Southwest 3rd Street. And we just want to give all the praise and glory and honor to God. It's God that does all this. And we just thank Him. And we thank Larry and Jewel for being on the air with us tonight. Mm-hmm. And we just look forward to next week for, I'm not sure who it is, but thank you, God, for whoever you bring. Mm-hmm. It'll be good. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thanks for watching. I believe in miracles. I hope you guys do too.
Amen.